Welcome back, fellow food geeks. It's good to have you back. So we made hummus, and now we have to make falafel because we cannot break up a pear now. This is a Middle Eastern dish, and this is the most authentic version, and you'll love it. Let's get started. So I have taken 1 cup of chickpeas. Now I have soaked them overnight. I am not going to boil them, just soak them overnight and now drain the water from it. Next, I have 4 to 5 cloves of garlic. And this is cilantro or coriander, so 1 cup of that. Usually we use parsley in the recipe, but as I don't have it, so I'm using cilantro, which is equally good. And around half an onion. Now I'm going to put all these things in the blender. Along with some salt to taste, because I haven't salted the chickpeas at all till now. Now I'm adding around 1 tablespoon of cumin in it. And now I'll add all the chickpeas. Remember to remove the water though. Now I'm adding 2 green chilies. These are not very hot. These are mild chilies. If you like it hot, add extra. If you don't like it hot, do not add the chilies. It's up to you. I'll quickly blend this all up and come back. So now I've blended it and this is how the mixture looks. You can see it's crumbly. It's not bindable yet. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to take 2 to 3 slices of stale bread, day old bread, and I'm going to tear it up into pieces and I'm going to blend this. This will make it more bindable. So I'll quickly blend it and come back. So now you can see it's coming together in a clump when I do this. So that means this is now ready and we can now form our falafels. So I'm going to show you 3 shapes basically. So first I'm going to show you a round ball shape. So now you have to turn it from hand to hand, take it from palm to palm and compress it and make it into a ball. This is how you make the round falafel. So this is ready. This is the ball. Let me show you another shape now. So this is an oblong cylindrical falafel. You can serve it like this as well. And the third one we'll make into a disc. Now I've taken all the mixture and formed all 3 different types for you to see. These will all fry equally well. So I'm going to fry. The first one is used more for pita pockets. The second one is served more as a snack. And the third one can be served any which way. So let's go and heat up our oil. I'm just checking to see if the oil has heated up. I think it has. So it's now time to put in our falafels. Just drop them in the medium to hot oil. So it's been 2 minutes. Now we can start turning them. Just be careful, they are still delicate to handle. So just turn them around, all of them. We can turn them once more. Basically make sure they're all golden brown, and when they are golden brown, you can take them out. I think they're almost done. Now they can be taken out. They're fully done now. We can take them out. Now I'll put the next batch in, whatever's left. And we're going to fry them the same way. I really want to just pick one up and eat it. Hot, piping hot. And I'm going to do just that. You wait and watch. See, I'm eating it. I just wanted to show you the texture inside. It's all fully cooked. You can see the steam escaping. It's not raw. It's fully cooked. And it's delicious. So it is a snack you must make. You can have, you can serve it in a pita pocket. You can serve it in a kaboos. You can serve it inside a sandwich with some hummus. You can actually serve it as an hors d'oeuvre. You can make smaller sizes of it. Really, you can do anything you want to do. So So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done so. Press the bell icon. I will be putting up the same video in Hindi for your reference as well, in case you enjoyed that better. I hope you have a wonderful day and you make this recipe, and write in the comments box how it was when you made it. So stay safe and I'll catch you later.